On April 12, 2024, at 5:11 a.m. local time, the Taal Volcano south of Manila in the Philippines produced an unexpected explosive eruption. Although web cameras in the crater were not working at the time of this eruption, more distant cameras soon recorded a plume of steam and volcanic gases rise to a height of 2,400 meters or 7,874 feet. Based on the height of the generated plume, the initial explosion may have looked like this 2022 eruption, albeit about two-thirds of its intensity. As shallow magma continued to interact with the near-zero pH water in Taal's central crater, the reaction created a series of small to moderate-sized explosions, with at least 13 occurring in a two-minute-long time span. As the minutes after the initial explosion passed, additional smaller explosions occurred, continuing to release small amounts of lava for the next 13 minutes until the activity ceased temporarily. What had just occurred was Taal's first eruption in the entirety of 2024, its first eruption since June 29th of 2023, and its largest eruption since a sustained 90-minute-long eruption on March 26th of 2022. However, the eruptive episode was not over just yet. Over the following 11 hours, an additional 4 more explosions occurred, generating 100 to 300 meter high plumes, which created bursts of gas, ash, and rock, which were recorded by webcam. In total, at least 18 phreatomagmatic bursts occurred, involving a combination of water flashing to steam and exploding, alongside fresh lava fragments. If we freeze a frame during one of these explosions, we can see that there is a multicolored black and white plume. The white coloration represents primarily water vapor, while the black represents ash and small fragments of lava. All of this activity occurred in the southwestern portion of Taal's acidic crater lake, also blasting away small sections of adjacent ash-covered rock. The source was a brand new volcanic vent located approximately 200 meters southwest of Vulcan Point, the famous island within a lake within an island within a lake within an island. The new vent, in my interpretation, represents the culmination of events which have occurred at Taal since April 20th of last year. While most of the Taal volcano island has been deflating due to a general decrease in the supply of underlying magma after its destructive 2020 VEI-4 eruption, April 20th of 2023 marked the beginning of minor uplift occurring on both the northern and southeastern sectors of the same island. I suspect that a dike of magma had been slowly intruding underneath Taal's lake since that date, which caused increased volumes of sulfur dioxide to be released. The presence of significant sulfur dioxide emissions at a volcano directly correlates to a body of shallow magma being present. While Taal only released an average of 3,800 tons of sulfur dioxide gas each day in 2023, this figure slowly increased throughout the entirety of that year until, in 2024, it averaged 10,248 tons a day. Surprisingly, this did not trigger any notable volcanic earthquakes or tremors, which have occurred at a lower rate than would be expected, suggesting that all of this movement may have occurred at very shallow depths and in a seismic zone. Now, depending on the number of earthquakes and sulfur dioxide gas figures over the next several days will help determine what will happen next. I consider the most likely scenario to be that more phreatomagmatic explosions will occur over the next several days, but will be small in size, being owed to the intrusion only having negligible amounts of andesite magma. These bursts occur quite randomly, although 85% of recent bursts occurred on days when the volcano produced more than 8,000 tons of sulfur dioxide gas. At this time, the alert level of Taal is remaining at 1, with the exclusion zone remaining as the entirety of Taal Island and Taal Lake. I do not see a reason to suspect that a far larger 2020-like eruption will occur, meaning that no evacuations are currently required. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Steve Muller for supporting this channel.